Okay, guys, so for this one, it's a little confusing. I'll start out with this. So basically, I'm an NFL owner right now. I'm part of the NFL draft, I guess, now. All you need to know is, basically, I'm looking at all the NFL teams, looking at their resumes for why I should buy them. Because if they don't make the playoffs, or like, let's put it this way. The team I pick has to make the playoffs. If they don't, I go bankrupt and I go to jail, basically. So I got to look at every single resume. I got to see which team. Obviously, there's other teams I'm wanting to pick. But I'm looking at which team I should go and buy. And I have to make the playoffs for them. So if the resume is bad, I'm obviously not going to buy them. Let's see how good the resume is. I'm going to rank them. Hit that intro. So, of course, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the NFL. Like and subscribe. Hope you guys enjoy. But we're going to look. I'm just going to basically tell you this here. So, there's no way I'm buying that team. Bad. It's a bad resume. Like, there's no way. Below average. It's not a great resume. Average. I mean, it's whatever. I don't think it's going to be the worst. Good. It's a good resume. Like, good stuff on it. Great. It's a very, very good resume. It's a lot of stuff that I'd like to see from him. Solid option means I don't, like, they're going to make, honestly, it's like, they're basically going to make the playoffs for sure. Elite, there's no way they're not making playoffs. And I'm going to buy this team. This is the team that I think is not only going to... It has the best resume, basically. Yeah, but if you have an elite resume, probably can get hired a lot, and a lot of teams, people would buy you. Ironically, we're starting out with the Bills. Resume. But here it is. Ironically, of course, it's the Bills. But I just need to check something really quick. So we got the Dolphins. I forgot how I did the scheduling. It's a little funky. Yeah, second. Did I mean this by how hard it was or how good it was? Yeah, never mind. So, we'll get starting off. Their roster grade was an A. That was first. Second in points at 198 out of 235, which is second. So their resume starting off is very good. First and second in two categories and very good. Strength of schedule is not great, though. They have a really hard schedule. Of course, when you're a really good team, you're not a really hard schedule, so that's a little concerning, but obviously not for sure. Defense and offense were both number one, so that's a very good start out with this. Getting right to where I'm going to rank them. Honestly, I can't put them in the first yet because I haven't seen other teams' resume, but I'll put an elite for now. They were probably a lock to make the playoffs. Of course, like with that schedule, maybe not, but I really like their resume. The Bills, a lot of teams would want to buy, people, owners would want to buy the Bills. I'm definitely, if I was going to buy one, them, I'd be one of them, of course, with that amazing resume. Let's get right to the Dolphins, though. Okay, for the Dolphins, their resume starting out, they get a B-, which is 19th, and, for points, it was 19th as well, so, just 19th in all, so it's a little bit below average. Their schedule, though, second in the AFC East, which is good for them. They have the 12th easiest schedule in terms of strength of schedule, which is really good for them. So I like their schedule. Roster grade-wise, their roster doesn't look anything special. And then tiers, looks like their offense is a little lackluster in terms of 14th, but it's still decent. Defense is top 10. Overall, I think they have a good resume. It's a little hard for, I can't say they have an average resume, because I think they have a good resume, they're going to be a good team, but obviously, it's a little high risk, high reward with this team, of course, with that, not great roster, and a good schedule, and a promising, tier ranking. I think, of course, this is, the tier ranking is the last thing, but I'd say it goes roster grade, schedule, then tier ranking, but with that tier ranking and that schedule, I think they have a good resume. I don't know if you'd want to buy them for sure, but I don't think it's a bad choice, especially if you're a high-risk, high-reward type of person. Now we're on to the New York Football Jets. Okay, so, of course, their roster grade is not very promising. 26th and 25th for their grades there, so that's not very promising. Their schedule is 3rd in the AFC, 16th, basically right in the middle for a team that isn't very good in terms of their roster talent. It's a little concerning that they're right in the middle in terms of their schedule. But in tier, they're even worse. Like, offensive tier, they're really bad. Defensive tier, they're better, I guess, but obviously not great. So I'm going to be completely honest with the resume. I think it's a bad resume, but it has some promise. But again, with that awful schedule and that really below average roster and, like,
not great tier ranking. I got to put them in bad. I don't think there's no way I'm buying the Jets because the Jets do have some talent for this season. They've got a long shot, of course, making the playoffs, but there's definitely worse teams I would take, resumes I'd take over. Okay, now we're looking at Bill Belichick's season resume. Of course, their roster grading, it's a little below average, I'll put it that way, but that's just because they're not the most talented team this year. That's being completely honest. They have the easiest schedule in their division, though. That's very important. Their defense is very, very good. Elite, top five. But their offense is meh, good, 21st. So, overall, I don't think this is a great resume. Of course, it's very inconsistent. I'll put it that way. But honestly, with the Patriots, I'll put them right next to the Dolphins. I think their resume is decent. It's a lot more inconsistent than the Dolphins. But, and the fact that it doesn't look great. Of course, there's not a lot on here for me to be like, whoa. But I don't think it's a bad resume whatsoever. Of course, with that top five defensive tier and a very promising schedule, I think you can definitely say the Patriots have a good shot at making the playoffs. I think it would be a good, definitely safe team to pick. Okay, now going on to the Cincinnati Bengals. Why should I buy the Bengals? I don't know. They have a top 10 roster in terms of overall. They're points wise, they're ninth, which is like really just like the math part. But roster, their grade is a B+. Eighth. Strength of schedule is ridiculously hard. It's ridiculously hard in the whole NFL, so that's a little concerning. Tiers-wise, their defense is a little bit out of the top 10. Their offense is, like, elite. Very, very good. Almost the best. So, I think the schedule is a little concerning, so I don't know if I can put him in elite, but I definitely think they're definitely a very solid option to pick. Of course, they're not. A lot of people don't think they'll win their division, but I do think this is a very, very, very... You know, I'll put him in great. Because that schedule is brutal, you know what, they're a top 10, I think they do deserve it, but their offense should be very good. It's a little bit of a risky team to pick, but I put them right at 10 for a very risky team. I do think they go there without that talent as well. This is the team that could be very, very good again. Of course, they went to the Super Bowl, so you have that reasoning too, but I'd say this is definitely a risky team to buy, but I would not say I personally would take it over a lot of other teams. Let's get right to the Browns. The Browns resume. Okay, so interestingly enough, they have like a rounded out, it's like the 15th, so a little bit below above average in terms of their roster, which I guess is good. I guess so. Strength of schedule, it's third in the division. It's nothing really that special. I mean, it's okay, I guess. But tier ranking is a little lackluster again. I don't know if I love this resume. Of course, with the team itself, I gotta put them in below average because it's so risky. You know, I'll put them in average. With that talent on that team, it's so crazy. But of course, with that quarterback situation, you just don't know. But I do think with that roster, you have to admit this team won't be absolutely dog water. I honestly do think if they can at least tread water without Deshaun Watson, you just gotta think that they can at least make the playoffs. But again, I think this is a decent resume just for the fact that, again, they do have a very talented team, but their roster is, like, good. But it's just, like, it's really inconsistent. Okay, now let's get to the next team. Okay, this Ravens resume, it's looking really nice because we look at the roster grade, it comes out to, like, a fourth or fifth, I'd say. Their grade is sixth, but their points is third, so they have a very talented overall roster. They have the easiest schedule in the AFC North, which is huge, huge leg up on all the other teams. And they have the literally seventh best tier ranking, so... Do I think they have a top five resume? Yes, just for the fact that it's just the schedule that really gets me. Because their roster is a top five roster. And their in their tier rankings top 10. But with that schedule, you just got to think. 10th easiest in the NFL, it's a top five resume. If there's a team that I really picked to be a lock, it would be the Ravens, just for the fact. Unless Lamar gets hurt, obviously, that's the little risk. But again, the Ravens are a very solid option to pick to buy if you want to buy a team. It's kind of like... betting on a team to win the Super Bowl away, but to make the playoffs, really. Team that you bet on to make the playoffs, I'd say with that, it's really just based on the resume. It's, other than, of course, maybe the Bills, this has been the best resume I've seen so far with that schedule. That's really nice. Let's get to the next team. Now on the Pittsburgh Steelers, of course, roster-wise, it's bottom 10, actually. Like, low bottom 10. So, roster-wise, it's not great. Schedule-wise, it's not an easy schedule, but it's somewhat favorable for a team that isn't the worst in their division. So, offensive and defensive rank, it kind of comes out to, like, a little bit below average. So, you look at it, it's not looking so great for the Steelers in terms of their resume. It's really a lot of inconsistencies, a lot of uncertainty, really. I'm not very confident with their schedule. I mean, their resume. I'll put it in below average. You know, I'll put it in average. It's hard. Their roster's bad in 10. Their schedule's somewhat favorable. It's decent. Their tier is not so favorable. So, below average. Yeah, they got a below average resume. I'm hard to put that there, but their resume is not great. I'll put it that way. Next team. Okay, so the Colts resume, of course, I have them at B, but it's just literally because I'm a wimp. But yeah, 16th. And then 8th. So it's really 8th. Let's put it that way. The Colts have a top 10 roster. They actually have a very favorable schedule as well, so that's very nice to see. And, of course, defense and offense, it's, like, kind of just coming out to average. But, honestly, really, the Colts have a very nice resume. I do like that a lot. It's a very confident one as well. Obviously, with the Titans in that division, though, you really don't know, so it's a little risky there. I can't put them in great just for the fact that it's a little uncertainty, because we don't know if they don't win that division. It might not make the playoffs. For that reason, I got to put them in good. It's a little bit of uncertainty in Indy, but as a resume... And, of course, with that uncertainty, I got to put them in good instead of, because roster-wise, they're a good roster, but, like, and the resume's nice, but, again, I can't put them in great just to back with that uncertainty with the, if they can make the playoffs as a wild card. Okay, so we look at the Jags roster grade. It's pretty bad, I'll put it that way. Talent-wise, it's second to last in the NFL, I'll be honest with you. It's really bad roster. Schedule is actually not favorable whatsoever for them, even though they have the 6th easiest schedule, and that's actually somewhat nice for them. Defense, kind of the same thing, it's bottom 5, it's a really bad roster. I don't think it's no way I'll put it in bad, because they're still a small, slim shot they make the playoffs. But their resume is pretty ugly. I wouldn't say it's almost as bad as the Jets, but at least the Jets have, like, some more talent. They're both very bad resumes, though. It's not like no way, but they're bad resumes. Okay, for the Texans, this is the worst roster in terms of talent, in terms of what I had to grade them. So, if you're a Texans fan, this is not starting out great. And they have the hardest schedule in the division as well. And defense, and their grading is, again, bottom 5. I guess their offense is decent, but that's literally it. Texans, there's no hope, no way I'm buying you. I do think you have somewhat of a future, though, which is good. But again, this year... If I bought you, I'd be a fool for this year in terms of having to make the playoffs. And I would have had to, like, I don't know. I would die. I'm basically having to buy an NFL a team for my life. Yeah, there's no way I'm buying you. Okay, the Titans, I think it's kind of the same thing with the Colts. Their roster isn't as good as the Colts in terms of, like, their grading, so that's a little bit concerning. Schedule is the easiest in their division, though. That's very nice. And they have top half grade. So, yeah, I get the offense is a little concerning. But the fact they have the easiest schedule in their division kind of has put me in a great resume. Obviously, you could say, oh, the Colts, oh, no, they don't win the division. Yeah, but you got to remember, they're picking up some wins with that easiest schedule in the division as well. So, and with that well-balanced schedule, I think they have one of the best schedules in the division. Yeah, it's the 8th easiest compared to the Colts one, but again... I think it's great with that schedule. That schedule is really making me more confident why I should buy it over the Colts, but I don't think it's by much whatsoever. Okay, now moving on to the Gauntlet Division, the Broncos. Okay, the Broncos roster is a top half roster for sure, but it's not super promising. Their schedule, they do have the easiest schedule in their division, though, so that does give them a leg up there. Actually, it kind of comes out to like 12-11 in terms of their tier ranking, too, so... Their roster, I don't think I can put them in great, just for the, you know, I'll put them in great, because, we look at their roster, there's no way, I'm just being completely honest here, that schedule just gives me so much more confidence why I should pick them. Of course, even if they don't win the division, I do think out of any of the teams, of course, with that schedule, they do actually have a shot to win it. I mean, they do have a shot to be that wild card team. If there's gonna be a team in that division, like, being, hypothetically, if we're being, like, analytical... And the team that doesn't make the playoffs and would be a wild card would be the Broncos because they have the easiest schedule in the division. About an average in terms of the whole league, but they have the easiest schedule in the division, which is really important. Roster grade wise, it's probably the worst in the division. But again, with that schedule, it really helps. And of course, with a really solid tier ranking as well, I do think they have a great resume. I definitely consider buying them. And now you want to talk about high risk, high reward, that's literally the Chargers. Of course, roster-wise, they're top 10, sixth best roster in the NFL. Straight schedule, though, it's not pretty, I'll put it that way, but it's not the worst in the league. In terms of their tier rank, again, top 10, basically, So I was gonna give them a grade. I'd actually put them a grade as well. Of course, their schedule isn't pretty with that talent though, and the fact they really don't play any crazy hard games, like outside the division, obviously, and the fact they have the arguable best offense and probably the best offense in the division. I put them in a great resume. Of course, you could say, "Oh, very risky." It is very risky. I get that, but again, it's the Chargers in terms of their roster is the strongest in this division, along with a very solid tier ranking, and the fact that their schedule isn't absolute. It's pretty bad, but it's not the worst, the worst, the worst. So that's why I got to put them here. But yeah, I think they have a very good resume. Right? Of course, the Broncos, of course, are not as good talent wise, but again, with that schedule, you got to really consider that as well. Chiefs resume. Okay. Their roster is the fifth best in the NFL, which I get in terms of my grading. They've got a very hard schedule, though, so that is something to be. And they got third hardest in the NFL, so that is not something you want to be happy about. Defensive tier is not good, and their overall, it's really just an inconsistent tier ranking, being completely honest there. So, yeah, that's not nice to see. But with Patrick Mahomes, I think they actually have a good resume, but again, I'm being completely honest. If it was last year, it would be here. But, again, with that schedule, I'm being an owner, I'm being completely honest, I don't know if I can pick the Chiefs, because, oh yeah, they're probably, you know, I'll put them in grade, because they'll probably make the playoffs. And, in fact, I'll be completely honest, a little more comfort when it comes to the Chiefs, because they've been so, so good with Patrick Mahomes, Andy Reid. So, with that in mind, I think they have a great resume, but again, it's a little less confidence than it has been in the past. Let's get to the Raiders. Okay, the Raiders' resume. Of course, when we did those roster grading videos, kind of came out to about 15th in the NFL, but they do have a very good roster. They have the hardest schedule in the division, which is very concerning in terms of my ranking, but 7th hardest in the whole league in terms of statistically. Roster-wise, it comes around, like, average, I guess, in terms of the tier ranking. So, I'll be honest with you, I wouldn't say it's, I gotta put an average resume. I don't think it's an average resume, but again, it's so hard for me to pick them, like, I'll be honest with you. This is just their resume on paper. It's not like you're not keeping a Derek Carr. Oh, I have this. This is just what I have right here, the statistically. And what I've been given, I think they have an average resume, which is just these teams in the division. And the fact they're the least talented roster in terms of this. So, yeah, I got to put them there. It's hard for me to do, but I do think that's where they go. Okay, now we go on to the Commanders. Commanders, of course, actually have a pretty decent roster. It's top 20. Very easy schedule, very good for them. Tier ranking, again, top 20. I think they have about a decent resume. If they had to pick them, of course, I'd pick them. Of course, they don't have a good shot to win their division, but they have a really easy schedule, so they'll pick up some wins. So I don't think this is the best resume, of course, like ugly other numbers, but it's not the worst. I really don't think it's that bad. But, of course, with that schedule, you got to remember that, too. I don't think it's a good resume, though, because the talent just isn't really there. Next team. Okay, let's look at America's team's resume. They got a top 10 roster, easy schedule in the NFL, very important. Defensive tier is 15, 12, whatever you want to call it. Yeah, I guess they have a brutal start to the season, being completely honest there, but the Cowboys are a very solid option to pick. Oh, yeah, they probably won't make the playoffs, they won't make the division. But with the easy schedule in the NFL, yeah, I know they have a really hard start to the season, but other than that, it's literally just a cakewalk the rest of the season, so... Even if the Cowboys start out 2-4, they're probably going to win, like, 10 games. You got to remember that. Their schedule is very easy. So that's why I got to put them here. And even that, they're right. You know, I can't put them as an elite resume, but with that schedule, it is a very, very, very easy pick to be a top 10 option. Now, the Eagles resume, of course, everything's going to be good this year. I'm not on that yet, but of course, they have a top 5, they have an above average roster. They have the hardest schedule in this division, though, even though it's really not hard whatsoever. And defense tier, offense tier, not great. So, resume-wise, it's right around average, but I'll put it in great. I mean, it's a very good resume in terms of the schedule, but, like, it's not that much talent, but I'll be completely honest. With that schedule, there's no way they don't have a great resume. I think they have a very good resume. Yes, I guess it's the points. It's not pretty, per se. It's, like, right around good, you could say at best, in terms of the resume, if you're just looking at those numbers. But... They've got a 30-day schedule in the NFL. There's no way they're not having a great resume. They've got they should have a good season. Next team. Okay, the Giants, talent-wise, they're a very bad roster, but schedule is third in their division, fourth easiest in the NFL. They've got a little bit of a mess in terms of the tier ranking. So the Giants, I gotta put in bad. I wouldn't say no way because you never really know with that schedule, but that's literally all I have to say about them. They argue with the worst off roster in the NFL. Okay, the best. Holy crap. Hell no! Okay, Lions. So their roster-wise, it's really not that talented. It's bottom 10, but it's not the worst in the world. Of course, their defense isn't great, but they have the second easiest schedule in the division, fifth easiest in the NFL. Tier ranking, again, not that great. I think they're a below-average option to pick. But obviously, they do have Dan Campbell, so you never know. And a lot of people, including me, I think they could have a very good season this year. And so, yeah, fringe, honestly, ceiling, they make the playoffs. So, if you want to be out there, you can pick the Lions. But I wouldn't buy them. It's a below average resume. But again, if you needed to buy them. Okay, the Packers, top sixth best roster in the NFL, again with the Ravens again. They have the easiest schedule in their division, though. That's very nice to see. In terms of basic tier ranking, it's top 10 again. I think there's not many more teams I would have picked over them. I put them, like, right here. Two, maybe even one. Their schedule's so easy, there's no way. I get to play in the Bills. They're playing some good teams. But with the fact they're playing, they have that easy a schedule. You could argue they have the best resume in the NFL. I'm not even kidding. But even, you're not banking on anything with Aaron Rodgers and Matt LaFleur. You know they're going to make the playoffs. So, like, honestly, they might go here. The team I'm going to buy would probably be the Packers for now. I'm not even kidding. But we'll see you in a second. Okay, the Vikings. Roster grade 19th in the NFL, so not very advantageous. Schedule's not hard, but it's not a great schedule. And they're about, like, middle of the pack in terms of their tier ranking. So, oh, God. Vikings, I put it in good. I mean, it's not, like, it's decent. Of course, you can say what you want about it, but... You know, I'll put an average. I don't really like their resume. I wouldn't buy them just the fact that... You know, I'll put it in good because they're usually a playoff team historically. In their resume, yeah, you could say what you want about it, but their offense is going to be decent. That's just how it is. Yeah, roster-wise, maybe not the greatest, but their schedule is pretty easy for a team that's supposed to be good. Okay, the Bucs, they actually have the second easiest schedule in their division, even though it's fourth hardest. Keeping that in mind, it's a really balanced schedule for them. Of course, they've got a top three roster, being completely honest. And tier ranking, yeah, it's a little lackluster, but it still gets the job done. I'd probably buy the Bucs if they had to pick a team to make the playoffs because it's Tom Brady, no offense. Yeah, I get he's a mess right now, but it's still Tom Brady. Next team. Okay, so roster-wise, their schedule is brutal for them. Roster, really not the worst, but it's basically the toilet, and yeah, they've got a very, very, very bad tier ranking. There's no way I'm buying the Falcons just for the fact it would take a miracle for them to make the playoffs. Not that I think the Falcons are a terrible team, but they are a terrible team, but yeah, you could say, the Jets, Giants, and both Jags, but at least they have somewhat of a cake. They've got some competitive games on their schedule. Falcons really don't, being completely honest, other than maybe the Panthers games, but yeah, it's a little bit of a mess for the Falcons. So for the Panthers, roster-wise, it's bottom 10, so it's not great there. But the schedule, not good either, but I guess it's not good. Tier ranking, average, so I think they have a below-average resume. I don't think it's a bad resume, but along with the Lions, it's just they're not really there yet, and they'd be a long shot to make the playoffs, but who knows? Okay, this Saints resume is very promising. They've got an almost top 10 roster. They have the easiest schedule in their division, even though it's the eighth hardest in the NFL. Tier ranking, very lackluster, but again, it works. So, if I'm being a Saints fan, I'd say you have a good resume. I wouldn't say you have a great resume. Of course, I'm going to shift this around in a little while. But, you know, I'll probably move the Chiefs up, Broncos up. Chargers can go right here. But, yeah, I really do like the Saints. I'll put it here. But completely honest, it's actually a very good resume. Very, very good resume. With the fact that they could win that division, but it's a little tough. Okay, Cardinals resume. Not pretty, I'll be honest with you, in terms of their grade. It's really a mess. Their schedule is the second hardest in the NFL and third in terms of the division. In terms of ranking, it's, again, lackluster. I'd say they have about an average... resume. Of course, you gotta realize they're gonna start the season off 5-2 or something like that. But I do not like their resume. It's a little all over the place. Okay, 49ers resume. They've got a top 10 roster. They got the easiest schedule in their division, and they have the a top 10 overall tier ranking. So for that, I think they have a very solid option if I was gonna pick a team to be make the playoffs. But again, with Trey Lance, you gotta realize that they might not even make it, but again, that's a long shot. I think they're the 10th best option in the NFL for a team that I'd buy, but again, with all they have, I don't think it's bad whatsoever. Now I'm going to my Rams. They have the first in terms of points, second in terms of grade, so they've got a top two roster. Schedule second hardest in the division, even though it's the hardest in the NFL by a mile, so they've got a brutal schedule, and they're tier ranking top five. I'll put them top five in terms of making the playoffs. I don't even know. They might not even win the division. But, again, with that schedule being the hardest in the NFL, you really never know. Let's get to this next and last team. I mean, last and yes, least, we got the Seahawks. And I'll be completely honest with you. They've got the hardest schedule in the NFL for any team. I'll be completely honest with you. I'll buy a birthday cake if they make the playoffs. Okay, so look at these all the teams' resume. I'm going to buy the Bucs if I was going to... For who has the best resume in the NFL? It's the Bucs. And yeah, you could say, oh, it's Tom Brady. Woo, yeah. Well, yeah, it is. I get he's a mess right now, but I don't really care. Yeah, if I was going to buy a team, it would be the Bucs. Because for it, if I had to buy a team that would make the playoffs this year, and if they didn't make the playoffs, something bad was going to happen, I would pick the Bucs. Then the Packers because of their schedule. Bills because it's the Bills. Ravens, schedule again. Rams because they just won the Super Bowl, and I like them. Biased. Whatever. Cowboys, schedule. Bengals, they're good. Chiefs, same thing. Broncos, kind of their schedule. Niners, because they're a very good team. Chargers, I have them in great. Titans and Eagles, because they all have pretty good, easy, favorable schedules. Chargers, maybe not, but they've all got pretty good rosters. Chargers are the best out of those. Dolphins and Patriots, both are different teams, but obviously they both have solid resumes. Colts, Vikings, nah, whatever. Saints, definitely whatever. Browns and Raiders. Well, Raiders, they're just in a tough predicament right now. They're the worst roster in terms of talent in their division. But that's just saying something because they do have that much chemistry. Whatever. The Browns are just a mess right now. But they do have a very talented roster. Washington, they're literally the definition of average. Cardinals, they're a mess again too. So inconsistent. Steelers and Lions. I mean, Steelers, they're just like a question mark, being completely honest. But Lions and Panthers. Long shots to make the playoffs, but they should be decent. Jets, Jags, Giants, literally here because they have so easy schedules. And the rest of these teams, I'd literally buy a birthday cake if one of them won. Literally. And if you didn't know, I don't like cake whatsoever. Yeah, that's the end of this video, though, guys. I would buy the Bucs if I, who has the best resume in the NFL and the team I had to buy if they had to make the playoffs, it would be the Bucs. Hope you guys enjoyed this fun video. Of course, this was actually very important, too, because the big video is tomorrow, and then it's right into the in-season. So, hope you guys enjoyed it. Let's watch some Kyler Murray to kick us off into the big video tomorrow.
Reverses. Murray. Looks long. He's got a receiver.